A former Topeka restaurant is coming down after years of sitting vacant.
Furs Cafeteria. The spot once known for its wide variety of food is now turning into rubble.
It was a...
No cameras what? First of all, don't touch the camera. 110 violations?
The restaurant industry is no stranger to challenges. And as we step into 2024, several major restaurant chains find themselves in precarious positions. Factors such as changing consumer preferences, economic uncertainties, and the aftermath of global events have left these establishments grappling with financial difficulties and declining popularity. Here are 12 major restaurant chains that are currently facing big trouble in 2024. 1. Boston Market. Following its acquisition by the Rohan Group in 2020, Boston Market, the fast casual restaurant chain, gradually slipped into obscurity until a multitude of ongoing lawsuits against the company came to light. Before the sale to Engage Brands under the Rohan Group of Companies in 2020, the American Rotisserie Chicken chain, headquartered in Colorado, was in the midst of a brand transformation aimed at revitalizing the struggling company. However, fast forward 4 years, and Boston Market is facing a dire situation. Local authorities have seized the company's Denver headquarters, and numerous locations are either closing, abandoned, or resorting to stocking their shelves with supermarket food as vendor contracts expire. As of August 2023, Boston Market was confronted with a mounting pile of lawsuits from vendors and former employees who have not been paid. Comments from both current and former Boston Market executives indicate that the new owner has mismanaged the business to the point where the demise of the chain seems inevitable. 2. Pancho's Mexican Buffet. Pancho's Mexican Buffet stands as a symbol of a bygone era, reaching its peak popularity in the 90s and early 2000s, a time when television commercials were at their zenith. Nostalgic consumers on the internet fondly recall the once prominent chain's jingle, a tune that played so frequently on their television sets that it became eternally etched in their memories. However, in 2017, the chain's owners initiated store closures due to lackluster performance and introduced a small store concept named Cuban Cafe. Regrettably, Pancho's has experienced a gradual decline since its golden age, dwindling from approximately 140 locations at its zenith to merely two struggling establishments in Texas. These remaining locations persist in offering all-you-can-eat tacos and sopapillas. 2 years ago, Texas patrons, disheartened by rumors of an imminent permanent shutdown reported by local news, gathered at the doors of the final Pancho's locations. Strangely, the anticipated closure did not materialize at that time. However, it seems that 2024 might mark the culmination of Pancho's journey, signaling the end of an era. 3. Fuddruckers. In 2010, the burger chain Fuddruckers Inc. and its parent company, Magic Brands LLC, sought refuge in Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection. Despite the challenges, the brand successfully navigated the turbulent period. However, more than a decade later, the restaurant chain is facing significant setbacks. The Fuddruckers, located at 900 Broadway, is now set to cease operations by the conclusion of 2023, bringing an end to its more than 35 years in business. Adrian LeBlanc, the owner of the Saugus franchise and a dedicated presence at the restaurant for 23 years, expressed regret about the closure, stating, "It is with a heavy heart that we are announcing the closing of our Saugus location. This is not the outcome we had hoped for, as we genuinely wanted to keep the restaurant open. Despite multiple attempts to negotiate a fair lease, however, we were unable to reach an agreement with our landlord, compelling us to make this challenging decision. While an exact closing date has not been determined, we anticipate shutting our doors in mid to late December and are grateful for the opportunity to continue serving our incredibly loyal guests until then." 4. Piccadilly Restaurants. During the height of the immensely popular all-you-can-eat culinary trend, Piccadilly thrived as a cherished family restaurant, serving as a reliable source of nourishment for hard-working American families. However, the outlook for the restaurant chain in 2024 appears grim, with several Piccadilly establishments shutting their doors this year. The Piccadilly Cafeteria on Airline Highway in Gonzales declared its closure in March. In June, the last Alexandria Piccadilly Cafeteria concluded its 56-year run. September witnessed the closure of Piccadilly's final Jacksonville Cafeteria after 50 years in operation. The cafeteria, located at University and Beach Boulevards, added to the disheartening trend by posting a sign on its door, signaling permanent closure. expressing deep sadness, an employee with 16 years of service remarked, "It was heartbreaking." Despite the closures, there has been no official statement from Piccadilly regarding the reasons for shutting down in Jacksonville. As of 2023, the future looks bleak for Piccadilly restaurants, with the chain mysteriously shuttering prominent locations one after another. 5. Crystal. Our go-to spot for square slider near the freeway exit cravings may soon need to change, as Crystal has faced multiple bankruptcies in just a few years. In the past 20 months, the chain secured a $59 million loan, underwent changes in leadership with a new CEO, president, and CFO, and closed 44 locations, with over a dozen shutting down in December alone. This has left around 300 operational restaurants across 10 states. In court filings, a multitude of reasons were cited for Crystal's struggles, including waning consumer enthusiasm for greasy fast food, stiff competition from various fast casual alternatives, challenges in hiring low-wage employees, expensive leases, and the escalating costs of food. The rapid surge in convenient online delivery from local restaurants has also dealt a harsh blow to Crystal, which predates McDonald's by 23 years. For nearly 90 years, its drive-through locations near suburban freeway exits were a key attraction, but they have gradually become obsolete in the face of evolving consumer preferences. 6. Fur's Fresh Buffet. Established in 1947, Fur's, a cafeteria-style chain, faced severe challenges during the pandemic. With communal food troughs becoming impractical amid COVID-19, the franchise closed all its locations at the peak of the virus. Unfortunately, to the disappointment of devoted patrons, these establishments never reopened, and as of now, all the locations either remain unused or have been demolished. In 2021, both Fresh Acquisitions LLC and Buffett's LLC filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy, over a year into a pandemic that proved exceptionally challenging for their 6 restaurant chains. 5 of these specialized in Buffett-style service. Remarkably, this marked the 5th instance where the company's various chains sought federal debt protection since 2008, grappling with substantial debt, cost-cutting measures, and a shift in consumer preferences away from all-you-can-eat concepts. Entering the pandemic, Fresh and Buffett's oversaw 90 restaurants under the Tahoe Joe's, Old Country Buffet, Hometown Buffet, Ryan's, Fire Mountain, and Fur's brands. Now, almost nothing remains, and 2024 may witness the permanent closure of their doors. 7. Applebee's. In an attempt to address escalating challenges, the renowned international chain Applebee's announced unexpected closures in August. According to Restaurant Business, the initial projection of 10-20 closures was surpassed, with Applebee's planning to shut down 25-35 net locations. These closures were part of a strategy to eliminate underperforming establishments and steer the chain back towards growth, marking a new chapter in its turbulent journey. Having faced over 300 closures since 2017, Applebee's has been tirelessly striving to regain a foothold in a fiercely competitive market. In a bid to attract budget-conscious customers, Applebee's has recently rolled out various promotions and deals. One notable reintroduction is a fan-favorite deal, allowing customers to add a dozen double crunch shrimp to any steak entree for just $1. Additionally, the chain introduced $5 Sunshine Sips, featuring Long Island iced tea and Tipsy Sunset. The outlook for 2024 remains uncertain for the chain. 8. Old Country Buffet. Old Country Buffet, once the epitome of America's buffet and all-you-can-eat dining, offered a haven for those seeking unlimited servings of steak, chicken, mac and cheese, potatoes, broccoli, soft-serve ice cream, and more, all at an affordable price. For many years, Old Country Buffet held the title of the go-to brand for Buffett-style dining. However, changes in culture, health consciousness, and shifts in food consumption patterns brought about by the pandemic have resulted in a significant decline in profits for Old Country Buffet over the past 2 decades. Regrettably, the majority of their storefronts have shuttered, and the remaining ones face uncertain prospects. The corporation has undergone bankruptcy proceedings 3 times since 2006. With the global pandemic encouraging more people to dine at home, the outlook for the chain as it approaches 2024 appears bleak. 9. White Castle. White Castle stands as the original global burger chain, having set the standard for all subsequent fast food establishments serving burgers and fries since its inception in 1921. However, there are indications that the enduring dominance of White Castle might be in jeopardy, given recent closures and financial challenges. The company faced legal troubles when one of its managers filed a lawsuit, and the repercussions could potentially cost White Castle a staggering $17 billion. In February 2023, a White Castle location in Illinois was found to have violated the state's laws concerning the use of digital identification systems. For a decade, employees had been utilizing a technology that neglected to inquire whether their personal information could be accessed through a third-party verification platform. This action is deemed illegal in Illinois, leading the Supreme Court to mandate that the franchise compensate for each occurrence of this violation. Unfortunately, a payout of this magnitude has the potential to severely impact a food franchise. 10. Pie 5 Pizza. When Pie 5, the fast casual pizza concept, made its debut in the summer of 2011, Pizza Inn proudly declared that it was redefining the pizza dining experience. Drawing inspiration from Chipotle, Pie 5 allowed customers to witness the assembly of their pizzas as they moved through the line. The initial plan was ambitious, aiming to establish up to 100 locations annually. Recognizing Pie 5's growth potential, Pizza Inn established the multi-brand platform Rave Restaurant Group in 2015. Despite opening its 100th store in February 2017, this marked the conclusion of the brand's upward trajectory. By the close of Q2 2021, Pie 5 had 34 units, reflecting a substantial 66% reduction in its footprint since reaching its peak in early 2017. The fast casual chain is now entirely franchised, with the last corporate store shutting its doors in 2020. While Pie 5 experienced a 15% growth in comp sales during Q2, there was a 1% decline over a two-year period. Currently, the fast casual is conducting tests in 4 stores, exploring a new decor, a refreshed specialty pizza menu, and placing a strong emphasis on house-made curated salads. The brand also introduced Mike's Sticky Fingers Pizza, featuring chili-infused Mike's Hot Honey. As 2024 approaches, only time will reveal whether it marks a new beginning for Pie 5. 11. Buffalo Wild Wings. Buffalo Wild Wings, renowned for its sports bar ambiance, diverse beer selections, and a menu centered around chicken, has been catering to game-watching patrons since its establishment in 1982. Nevertheless, more than 4 decades since its inception, a bleak cloud looms over the chain's future. Challenges appear to be emerging for this restaurant franchise. In a recent controversy, Buffalo Wild Wings faced criticism for serving what appeared to be wings to customers that, upon closer inspection, turned out not to be wings at all. When taken to court regarding this matter, the company admitted to using chicken breast prepared and fried to mimic the appearance of boneless chicken wings, rather than utilizing the actual wing portion of the bird. This revelation is disconcerting. If the prevailing negative sentiments among consumers and the questionable practices exhibited by the chain this year are indicative of future developments, the outlook may not bode well for Buffalo Wild Wings. 12. Steak and Shake. Steak and Shake's presence is steadily shrinking as the company undergoes transformations on multiple fronts. Exiting the first quarter of 2023, the brand closed 11 franchise stores and 2 company-operated ones, concurrently transitioning 3 corporate units into franchise partner models. This led to a total of 493 restaurants, down from the 626 locations recorded at the close of 2018. Biglari Holdings, the parent company, reported that, as of March 31st, 36 out of its 172 company-operated stores were shuttered. Of these, Steak and Shake has finalized plans to sell 7, while an additional 17 are listed with brokers for lease or sale. The intention is to refranchise the remaining closed company-operated units. Despite a reported overall improvement in the franchise's sales throughout 2023, the ongoing trend involves the closure of locations. The future remains uncertain, and we remain cautiously optimistic. The restaurant industry is dynamic, and the challenges faced by these major chains highlight the importance of adapting to changing consumer preferences and market trends. Whether through menu innovation, technology integration, or a reimagining of their brand image, these struggling restaurant chains must navigate the current landscape to regain their footing in the competitive food service industry. Otherwise, 2024 may be the year they shut down for good,